your strategy in the house?
I didn't have any strategy. You know, they asked me before when I auditioned, you know, what would be your strategy in the house? I've been asked that so many times. And I said, I don't have a strategy, man. My only strategy here is to go into the house here and just be myself. And that is it. And that's what I did. Dude, trying, like, for me, I feel like the kind of person I am, trying to, I'm a very emotional person. Okay. Trying to have a strategy, yo,
it
will be so obvious that I'm playing a game because I'm very emotional. I'm very, like, if I'm not happy, you know I'm not happy. Like, that is just me. So I think they'll probably, the housemate would have probably sussed me out. Would have probably voted me out a long time ago. You know, so I just said, let me just keep it real and just be myself. And that's what I did. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed my experience.
So including the kisses with the guys.
Hey! I can too taste their saliva.
Oh my.
Ew!
I remember it.
Chai!
You kissed the guys in the house now. Most, at least, yes, you kissed Kemen.
Chai!
Bali.
Hey!
Basi.
Oh!
John.
Mm-hmm.
Tony, did you kiss Tony?
Who is Tony? I'm joking. it was like everybody kissed each other. It was a game. When you're in a house, yeah, you know what? You invent stuff to keep your mind, I won't say keep your mind occupied, but to keep you sane somehow, you know? Because you have the task, you have anxiety over who's going, you have anxiety over nominations, eviction, this, that, you're putting on weight, this, you know, normal things. So sometimes you just create things. So the kissing game was an avenue for us to just relax and have fun. It's nothing. Sometimes you don't really fancy the person, but hey, you're being a good sport. Everybody's doing it, so why not? The first time we did the kissing game, I didn't play. But then I said, you know what? Let me loosen up a bit. Let me just join them and let me play. It was nothing anyway.
No, kisses meant nothing at all. So you didn't catch feelings in the house?
Maybe one.
Oh, yeah, tell us now.
Who do you think?
Let me see. Okay. I don't want to start counting off the guys like...
Ew, gross. Come on. I beg.
Okay, let me see. I want to say Kemen.
You want to say Kemen?
I want to say... That's why I said that.
Oh, was. Okay.
Okay, no, of course it was Bali. Because I remember the call.
Bali?
Oh. Okay, Tony. Oh. John.
Oh, please. I'm not even going to answer your question.
No. You just answered.
I'm so the...
Basi.
Going to answer your question.
You just answered. So you had a thing for Basi.
Hey, Ndeoguta, Biko, Yinamaka, help me. Help me, please. So, I would say, I'm not going to answer your question because...
You hope that when
you should have just said the person, but I'm sure somebody will guess.
Somebody will guess. Yeah. Okay, so you grew up in the UK.
Yes.
Up in the UK. At what point did you move back home?
I actually was born in the UK, and my mom just had me in the UK for papers, you know, as they do back in the day. They would just come, say that they want to come and visit their sister in London. Before you know it, Uriel has just popped out. So that's what happened in my case. After I was born in the UK, we moved back to Nigeria. Or sis, so sharp.
So
straight back to Enugu. So I lived in Enugu. For up until I was five, my dad passed away. And when my dad passed away, my mom just carried all of us and said, oh yeah, let's go back to the UK. Because my dad, we didn't have anything here, you know. And a lot of things went down. You know, when a woman loses her husband, a lot of things happen. So she just said, okay, let's just go back to the UK. And from the age of five till my adult age, I spent in the UK. So yeah, it was good, but you know, being in the UK, I used to always fantasize about coming back to Nigeria, coming home. It was just like I would just sit in school and I'd be like, oh, I want to come home. I always used to imagine stuff, but I'm here now, and I tell you what, I can never live in the UK again. Never.
Really?
Never.
You know, I asked this because a couple of guys are talking about your accent. You understand? People, while you were in the house, it was an issue for people because they felt, being the emotional person that you are, the expressive person that you are, when you're talking, sometimes you mix it with Igbo. You start your statement.
I'm a mess.
You start with proper British accent. Then, as the session is going, Then we hear Pidgin, we hear Igbo, we hear different things. Mm. So different form of accents. So I wrote an article about the fact that you were actually born and bred before people realized, because they felt you were just forming. Some called you the drama queen. So different type
of thing. No, I grew up in the UK. I went to nursery, went to primary school, I went to high school, middle school, I went to high school, I went to university. I mean, that's all I knew growing up. You know, I got there when I was, I think it was a few weeks before my fifth birthday, we got to the UK. So, I mean, that's me switching from Igbo to Niger to this, to Pidgin. That is just me. So like now I'm just, I don't know if I'm speaking UK Igbo, but sometimes that is just me. I can't help it. And I feel like I want to identify with my culture.
Okay.
And I've always been like that. In school, I used to do it all the time. I'll be talking and I'll put on one strong Niger accent. And people will be like, how did you do that? So it just became normal to me.
Okay.
That is just, it just became normal to me. And it's something that I do. I don't even think.
It's just you.
Like, I could be having a sentence with you.
Okay.
I'll be like, oh, can you pass me, Biko, can you pass me, Afara? So I'm speaking English, but I will not end it with Igbo.
Okay.
So you're like, what? And that's, it's just a part of me.
So no forming at all, nothing.
Not at all. I mean, I'm a Nigerian. I'm Igbo. I'm a Nigerian. I at least I try to speak Pidgin. The one I can speak, I speak it. The Igbo I can speak, I speak it. I just combine everything together.
Okay. You know what you go do now? We go talk English again.
I beg. Make we talk English.
No. You have to speak
English. No, my Pidgin. You know they used to always say, Uriel, say that again in Pidgin. Your Pidgin is so sweet. They would just be laughing at me. I beg.
No, you stay in the house with Ife now. Even if he stays, at least something for the role for at least something.
Yes, now I know. Even sometimes when I'm speaking my language, Ife will say, "Uriel, wait till you just talk now. You know, but man, I just mix it up. Me, that's just me. That's
okay.
My character.
Okay. Your name is Uriel Ngozi Oputa, and
yeah.
We all know the is an Oputa family that's quite very popular.
Really?
Come on, Charlie boy.
Hey.
Come on.
Are you? Wow.
There are different rumors playing.
Are they popular?
Come on, Uriel. Are you related to Charlie boy?
Wow, that's a nice painting right there.
Mm-hmm. Very beautiful. Very painting.
Wow, I like that painting.
Oh, wonderful.
I would like to find out where they got it from.
Maybe I'm done with the interview, we'll find out. Chance
for you. Wow, I like your shirt today. It's very nice.
Very
you look,
nice.
Look very, you look, wonder, you look like a takeaway.
Yes.
Green grass.
I get that a lot, Charlie boy.
Yeah, I am. He's my cousin. He's my cousin. But I call him uncle because he's older than me. So he's my elder, so I call him uncle. So yeah.
Okay, guys, we're having fun with Uriel in the house. We're having a lot of fun with Uriel. She's talked about her time in the house, including the person she had a crush on that she has refused to let us know. But please come and keep sending your comments and your reactions to this interview. I'm sure you're having a lot of fun. So let's take a couple of comments.
Hey.
Okay, Asha Killer is saying you've talked about all other stuff you want to do. I never thought about adding comedy to it.
Hey! I'm a comedian. You people have just fought my life today. Now I don't like music. Now I'm a comedian.
This is not.
Chai.
These are fans that are watching the interview presentation.
Chai.
This is just.
Calm down, help.
No, but really, have you ever thought about comedy?
No, I've never thought of comedy. Like, I don't look at myself as being a comedian. But I don't know, maybe, I don't know. No, I've never thought of it, but.
But it's something you can do now.
I don't know. Do you think I can do it?
Yeah, I think you can. Because I know recently I found out that you were on Eminence Africa, the show about actors.
Yeah, BET Top Actor.
BET Top Actor.
Yeah.
You understand?
I don't even know how I entered that show.
You don't know how
I don't even know.
Okay, you know, just tell us, how did that happen? Then how did Big Brother happen to you?
I just saw the audition and I went to Maryland, the Protea, and when I entered there, I would just see plenty Nollywood actors and this, that. No, I mean, not Nollywood actors as such, but up-and-coming actresses and actors, people that have done this, done that. This person has done this commercial. So me, I was just sitting there. I was like, hey, bro. I thought it was reality TV. Hey, bro, I don't know that I have to come and act. Hey, bro. Then I brought scripts. And I saw the script, I almost fainted. The English that was on that script, even me, I couldn't even understand. I said, hey, Uriel, you have entered one chance today. So when I got there, I was trying to memorize the script. Okay, I memorized it. As soon as I entered there, I now walked into the room. I saw like five people on the panel, the judges. Okay. Then they now said to me, okay, we've given you a script. Please do, you know, just start. My dear, let me tell you, when I got there, my mind was blank. Blankety blank. I just summoned some sort of emotion within myself, and I just did a freestyle. Mm-hmm. And it's actually online, actually. Okay. I actually did a freestyle, and they were like, when I finished, they were like this.
So they all carried away.
It was very dark. I did a very, like, I can't remember what it was, but I knew it was a very dark, kind of edgy something.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So that was it. Then how did the Big Brother one come up?
Same thing now. I did for house. I did for house. I released one song, mm-hmm. and one that song. No, not even one blog picked up. Hey, my life.
No.
Not even one blog picked up my life. As I released a song, not even one blog. Say, Uriel carried it. Uriel just released a song. Just there, they are looking at my phone, who we carry. Nobody, not even one person carried. I was just frustrated. And I saw, they're doing Big Brother audition. I said, okay, I like to be on TV. Let me try this one. Okay, let me try. So that day that I even went for the audition, let me not even go there.
Oh, come on.
Anyways, come on.
You just left us on the cliff now.
So anyway.
And I'm driving back. No.
And I saw the audition. Yeah. I said, after the audition, I said, okay, let me go. And I now auditioned. And that was it. The rest is history. But I've already auditioned for Big Brother. I auditioned for Big Brother Africa twice. Oh, and I got through to the final. And it was between myself and Beverly. Oh. So I went to South Africa. And photo shoot, did everything, and it was between myself and Beverly. The second time again, it was between myself and Lillian, but they picked Lillian over me. And then the third time, when I just released my song, and not even one blog carried it.
Are you frustration? I said this one.
In fact,
I just
put on my clothes, went outside, wait for taxi, enter taxi, straight to Maryland. That was the rest was history.
Okay, a couple of comments are coming in. Osarity, Douglas, Idu, I don't know. Please do let me mother your name. He says he loves you, Uriel. Halima Zuber saying, Uriel, one of my favorite housemates. We will miss your diary drama.
Hey!
You understand? Ugeji Tio is saying the same thing. Noel Dio, nice one, Uriel. Asaki let me saying, she is so funny. Somebody saying, Oluyeye Paul, Ayo Olua is saying, you are a very sensitive person. Uriel has explained.
I'm sensitive.
You've explained that. Someone is asking you to explain the tattoo on your jaw.
Which jaw? Okay. So, this is something that, I don't know if you watch like most Nollywood movies or whatever, but this is something, it's a tribal something. So, people from
Iboland?
Uh-huh. Iboland use this now. Hey, a lot. This is
it. Think you were Sunnis?
No, they do this a lot. And they now use uni. Uni is like coal. You now use it to rub on their mouth. They now do this. They now do their eyes. So in my culture, in Igbo land, it's a sign of beauty. It's some sort of like, you know how you do your lashes, mm-hmm. and you do your contouring. Back then, our ancestors, they used to use it to say, this was our mascara. This was our contour. This was our contact lenses. So this is a sign of beauty.
This is a sign of beauty.
A mark of beauty.
You mentioned you grew up in Enugu. Where are you from, actually?
I'm from Imo State, Uguta.
Uguta.
Uguta, beautiful place, beautiful lake. I'm from Uguta. And we like fish. I like fish. And Uguta women like to cook. They like, if they cook for you, white soup. Hey! Okay. Chai!
So now that you said you have plans to do like a cooking show where you have guests and stuff.
Yeah.
So if we at Nigerian.com invite you, mm-hmm. if we pause this show right now, get materials, and ask you to show the world, show Nigeria your cooking skills. Is that
why not? You guys should actually do something. You guys should actually arrange something where I'll come and do like a nice barbecue with Uriel. I think that would be cool. I'll do it. No wahala.
Say you like it.
Yes. No, but it's true now. You guys should organize something. I'll come and cook, and we all hang out, chill, eat. Yes, now you guys should do it. Please tell them to do it so, because I want to cook. And I want to invite you people to come and eat. Come and taste all the I can't pay, bush, and they cook for Big Brother house, I beg.
We will take that under advisement. Mm-hmm. We'll consider
it. Don't happen. They said yes, so it's okay. Okay. Moving on.
Okereke Agu is saying you're a very funny person. Israel Adeni said, you said in the diary room countless times that you were going to slump if evicted. Hey. He's saying he's waiting to see you slum.
Hey, why do you want me to? I rebuke it in Jesus' name. Hira baroke ba shake up.
No,
mm-mm. I'm not slumming for anybody, it's okay. But yes. Like I said before, I knew I was going,
okay.
So I was calm, my spirit was calm.
Okay.
But if I wasn't expecting it, it would have been a different thing, but I was expecting it, so.
Okay, so. Short star Olabode Kane is saying, what did you feel for Basi?
Hey, correct guy. I think for me, I just liked him. I love the fact that he's a good listener.
Okay.
And he is very intelligent. And he looked like Zumunda.
Three.
He looks like a Zumunda warrior. Mm-hmm. And hey, he can, oh my God, I can't even tell you. He likes to eat. I love a man that likes to eat. I love people. Forget man. Me, I've been
so when I said I like to eat, I said forget man.
I beg you. Oh, that's not fair. I love being around people, whether man, woman, children. I love babies. I love children. I love feeding people. I just want to feed people. And I love the fact that he likes to eat. So that's it. So he's just a nice guy.
So if he comes from the airport now, once if he leaves or even if he wins, all you just want for him is to come to your...
Come and eat. Bia, 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 bia. Come and eat.
Say, Basi, come and eat.
Ew, girls. Let's move
that's
on.
That's what you just said. That's what you just said. That's what you said. Okay, moving on. Poetry Doctor Adegoke Jr. is saying, you said you can never live in the UK again. Okay, we are come, we could exchange now.
Oh yeah, now, before Uncle.
So you give her your passport, you will go stay, you will go.
But my UK passport has expired, so I've been using my Niger passport, so I don't know which one you want to use.
Okay,
I only get Niger passports.
Adeyemi Osiles is asking, someone was a man during a shabo. Did you get paid for your time in the house?
Hey, boy. Hey. No. No, I didn't get paid for anything.
So none of the housemates will get evicted, get paid?
I don't know. Have you asked them?
Yeah, we did.
What did they say?
I would rather hear your own answer first.
Okay, so this is the deal, yeah? I don't know myself. Child, I don't know. I don't even know where my bank card is, so I don't even know. Listen, at the end of the day, the only person that wins money is the winner of Big Brother Niger. That is it.
Every other person.
I don't know for them more. I don't know for them more. Me, I just they hustle.
Okay.
I just want to cook for you people. Oh, no. Uh-huh, now. So like I just they hustle.
We'll take that on that.
Uh-huh.
Obi Martins is saying, I like you so much, Uriel.
Thank you.
You represented your culture very well.
Thank you.
In the house, the diary room is boring without you.
Oh man.
Please, I would like you to go into acting. What do you think about it?
Hey.
And before you answer, Jane Behanak is saying, wow, I love this ebony dancer.
Oh wow.
Okay, so what do you think about acting?
I'm not an actress, but I mean I love TV, so if the opportunity comes, definitely I would take it up. You see me, I'd be Igbo girl, eh? So anything they say you will do,
you
I'll do it. I will chuck my hand, chuck my leg, chuck my uku, chuck my head, chuck my everything. Everything will enter.
Chuck your what?
My uku.
Yo, I didn't hear you. Could you
my uku.
One more time, please. Guys, we are having fun in the house, and judging by the comments and everything, everybody's happy you're talking. Please keep your comments coming in, your reactions. Uriel is here. We are having a wonderful conversation. Okay, Emmanuel. Okay, oh.
Hey,
Omoya Tunde says, how do I meet you in person?
Hey, anytime you want to meet me, you contact these people because they are going to arrange a barbecue with Uriel.
Okay, so, yeah. Emmanuel Junior Chibuso Eguatu.
Hey, my brother, I hear you. I didn't hear you.
Do you never hear what I want to ask?
Hey,
he says, I never knew this girl is so real. Lord, forgive our sense of judgment.
Yeah.
Obina Onumaibu is saying the same thing. He says, Uriel is so real and full of life. Tonya Nili,
child.
She wishes she was here.
Hey.
Okay. Engineer Obitex Joe says, Uriel used to be my girlfriend back in high school.
Hey, it's a lie.
Tell her I am missing her from Heathrow, London.
Oh, yeah, but I don't know him. I don't know him.
You don't know him.
What's his name again?
Obitex Joe. Engineer Obitex Joe.
I don't know him. Engineer.
Well, you had a boyfriend back in
the day. I didn't have any boyfriend. My mom was a pastor. I didn't have any boyfriend. For me to go out, I would say that I'm going to Bible school. Mom, hey! So please don't get me into trouble. Oh,
okay. Jane, Bahana, you were my love. He said you are a very polished lady.
Hey, yeah.
Alexander Ashikibu says you are beautiful and you're awesome.
Oh, my friend.
You will get a good husband and a good job.
I receive it.
Ha! Asha Caleb is saying you're a sharp babe.
Hey, sharpness.
Jane is saying you're a black beauty.
Hey, blackness.
Like your personality.
Ah, personality.
Colin's editor. He says he hails the house from Singapore. He's watching from Singapore.
Hi.
He says it's quite interesting seeing Uriel, the queen of the diary room, right here.
Hey, yeah.
Have you seen Kemen or any of them?
Child.
I'll be happy to see my brother Basi marry her.
Hey! Oh God, Uguta, get ready. Yeah. Wedding is coming on.
Uriel and Basi.
Hey!
What will be the hashtag though?
I don't know. Tell them
see
to think
how
of
how you're blushing. Oh my God. Basi, when you do get to watch this, I beg you, please make the moves, press the button.
Story.
The signs are here. Okay, Mark is signing you or Babu.
Hey!
Asking. You said that you feel Efe is going to win.
Yes.
I have to ask, why? You've said this a couple of times already.
Because real recognize real. You know, Efe is a real G. Efe is my G. And based on logistics, I just feel like, I mean, he's a people.
Yeah, based on logistics.
Yes, so.
Do him proud.
Based on logistics.
Speaking pidgin.
I don't want to speak pidgin, but based on logistics, Efe is a real guy. And a real G. So. Waiting the people want here. My pigeon is whack. God damn it.
I was feeling you. I was feeling your pigeon.
Do you know what I'm wearing? Okay, I'll come back to this.
Okay.
Anyway, so I just feel like Efe is a real guy. Okay. And he is very determined.
Yeah.
And people love him. And I love him. He was so real to me. And he's the kind of guy where he's not afraid to take correction. Like, I always used to cook in the house.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes I'll be cooking my I can't pay stuff. And Efe, he will be like, Uriel, what thing you dey cook for this pot? Eh? It is not good. It is not very, very nice. Eh? But what thing be all of this? And then I'll be like, Efe, just wait. Let me finish. If I explain to you what I'm cooking, you won't understand. He'll be like, okay, because it's you, Uriel, I dey trust you. I know this food will be correct. So when I'm done cooking, he will eat. Even sometimes when I'm speaking my 2020 English, he will now say, Uriel, I don't understand. What thing you talk? Then I'll now explain to him. Then he'll be like, okay, nice one, my G. So for me, a person that is not afraid to take correction, even if he doesn't understand something, he says, I don't understand. He's just a real person.
Okay,
and so I love him. And I'm hoping he will give me even his 100K.
This is just
100K. Please. I will take it.
So you feel Triple T doesn't have a chance?
I don't know. Everybody has a chance, but man, I don't know, man. I just, for me, Efe. I don't know about Triple T. I don't know about anybody else. Bisola is my love. I love that girl. She's so cool. But for me, Efe is my G.
Okay. What is happening, people? What is happening? Why is everybody praying for you here? I pray for you, Uriel. God will make you the millionaire wife, mother, and personality you wish to be.
Hey!
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Adaimo. Your brother from all part of Imo.
Okay.
You are natural and I am proud of you.
Hey, yeah, Dalo, thank you so much.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
You've said it a couple of times. You've said it here countless times.
Yes, sir.
That you're a proud Igbo girl.
I'm a proud Nigerian and I'm a proud Igbo girl. I'm proud of Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
I'm proud of my where I'm from Imo State. I'm proud to be an Igbo girl. I'm proud to be a Nigerian.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all those days I lived in the UK, I always felt like something was missing, you know, because I left Nigeria a couple of weeks before my 5th birthday. But, you know, sometimes you speak to your cousins, you see their stuff on Facebook, and you just be wishing that you're in Nigeria. And immediately I stepped foot in this country as home. I just felt home. I'll tell you what, I traveled to Owerri. I didn't get to go to my village,
okay,
but I got to go to Imo State and I went to Owerri. I carried Aja. Aja is sand.
Okay.
I carried Aja from Owerri and put it in a plastic bag, okay. And I kept it. Till today, I still have that same
sound. Have that
many years later, because I just want to be connected to home.
Okay.
It has always been my dream to come back. My mom left when my dad passed away,
okay.
But to come back. And me coming back, I tell you what, my mom always said, I will never come back to Nigeria. Always bad memories, my dad passing away. I'm the person that brought my mom back after so many years. I'm the person that brought my brothers back after so many years. So you tell me, I love this country, honestly.
Okay.
It's country badass.
Okay, we have to ask, you understand, the issues around Nigeria nowadays, they are countless. But one issue that has come more and more, and a couple of people have dropped them, is the issue of Biafra. What do you think?
I can't tell you what I think. I mean, that...
Smile on your face.
You can't put me on the spot, but...
Okay.
You can't put me on the spot.
Of course,
but can I tell you something, what I really feel?
Okay.
I feel that my mom is amazing because she kept this jacket for so many years. And like, she wore this jacket. Look at the shoulder pad. This is...
Mother
Mary shoulder pads, and she wore it.
So this is your mom's jacket.
This is my mom's jacket. She wore it in the 80s, and I'm wearing it now. So look at my shoulder pad.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand? So this is amazing. Like I'm wearing something from the 80s. How cool is that?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think. That's but awesome. I'm not going to answer your question because I don't want to feel you know.
Whatever you say now.
I don't want to feel anything.
You are a celebrity.
Ah.
You are a celebrity.
That's even more of the reason. If anybody wants to ask me how I feel. Go to my Facebook page, drop me a message, and I'll surely answer you. Bam.
From there. Okay, moving on. What is the secret of your beauty? This, you look more beautiful outside the house. This is Onafeso Lawrence asking.
Do you know what? I don't have a secret, but I'll tell you what I use on my skin. Before I enter the house, I know I didn't get plenty money. I just have to manage. I will probably say it's wrong. You know, I'll go to Balogu market. They know me there. There's one of my auntie. I call her my auntie. She sells shea butter.
Okay.
And I always buy my shea butter for her. So what I use on my skin is shea butter from head to toe. That's what I use on my body. And you always use, you have as a woman or whatever, to maintain your color, you don't need to use skin lightening cream or skin toning cream. A good skin sun protecting cream is very, very good. So go and find sun protecting cream or lotion, put on your face to protect your face from, you know, getting dark because of the whole walking around on the streets, you know. And I use everything. I use cheap makeup. I use expensive makeup. I buy makeup from markets. I buy makeup from a supermarket. Whatever. I just use whatever suits me. It doesn't have to be expensive.
It doesn't have to be.
I'm not the kind of person, I only use Gucci. No. Sometimes I can put Gucci on my face or put Gucci lip gloss on my face and it will not suit me. Go out there. Yes, now. Go
Gucci
out.
Lip gloss.
Yes.
Hey.
Go out there and find out what suits you. It doesn't have to be expensive. You don't have to break the bank. Simple.
Simple. Now, just keep it real.
Keep it real, man.
Okay, we have to ask.
This is my child's eyes. If I tell you where I got it from, I won't even tell you.
You said it, Balogu market.
Yes, now, 500 naira, straight up. And where I wear it, okay, don't want 500, 1K. When I wear this child, people always ask me, where'd you get it from? If I tell you where I got it, you'll never believe me. It's only certain people that I tell where I actually bought the trouser from. I got it from Balogu market now, 1K.
Oh.
Yes, now. So, it doesn't matter. You don't have to go and break your bank to look so special. You mix it up.
Okay, guys, thank you very much for joining us in this interview. We've had a couple of wonderful, wonderful sound bites from you.
Yes.
A lot of people have been asking about, it's okay, stop praying for you, it's okay.
Yeah.
Came in.
Mm.
Serious. It happened the week you were evicted.
Yeah.
You understand? What shame. Are
you talking about? I mean, it happened, it unfolded before my eyes.
So you actually saw the whole thing happen?
Yes, when Kemen left the house, I was inside the house.
Okay.
Then I left after.
Okay.
I don't know, I haven't watched the video, so I can't give you a definite...
Why haven't you watched the video though?
I just don't want to watch the video right now. And I haven't had the time to sit down and watch it. So I can't give you my opinions on something that I have not seen.
Okay.
But what I will say is, it is a shame. You know, this whole thing is a shame for both of them. It is a shame for both of them. It's sad, you know, and I really feel for both of them. And I mean, Kemen was my friend in the house, and he's my friend.
Okay.
But it's just a shame, you know. I just pray that God will guide both of them, and you know, that's all I can say.
That's all you can say. Yes. All right, thank you. Okay, Engineer Obitex Joe, the guy who said he was a boyfriend in in the secondary school in the UK, he says, why are you denying me?
Hey,
tell her I am still with the flower she gave me on
April 2013. Hey,
you have a
2013 in high school. Nah, that's a lie now. How old am I? I'm 30 years old. So how will I enter? See, you people are trying to form my hand. So you say that I entered high school at my old age. Hey, I have been.
Cast them, no?
No, I don't. Please, Engineer
Obitex.
Obitex. I beg now. We'll make you know some my market now. Please, because.
Okay, one more question, Uriel. The president came back.
Oh, wow.
Come on.
If I tell you the amount of waka I did waka for this weekend, I don't even know. I've only spoken to my mom twice since I've been back. So, okay, I've heard he's back. Okay, that's really good. How do you feel?
My touch, no matter, I'm not a celebrity here.
You're my celebrity?
Oh, come on.
Okay, how do I feel? I feel like, wow.
Okay, if you were to meet the president right now, like now, with all the issues, with all the waka, we don't waka, you understand, and you've been in Nigeria for a while now, what would be that thing you tell him to change? Or what do you think he should tackle immediately, that without time wasting anything?
I don't know, but I would just say one thing. I would just tell the president to please listen to the mass, listen to the voice of the people. I mean, that is just it, you know, listen to people. Sometimes, you know, generally, sometimes we feel like, okay, we know what is right and what is not right, whatever. But sometimes it's good to listen to people and listen to the people that actually live a normal life in Nigeria. There's no harm in that. So that's my only advice. Just listen to the people, you know, and you can learn one or two things from the mass, from the Nigerian people. We are great people. So that's my advice, definitely.
Just that. Okay, one more question. Shady Ashafa is saying, Uriel, are you an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo?
Aquarian. I'm Aquarius.
Okay, so Shady, you have your answer. Guys, thank you very much for joining us. Thank you very much. It's been an amazing conversation I've had with you in the house.
Thank you.
Yeah, a lot of people had different misconceptions about you.
But yeah.
In this interview, according to our comments, they have talked about the fact that they now see that you are a real person. And shout out to everyone that has watched this interview. Shout out to those that have shared. And please, let's not forget, our interviews organized courtesy 1107 Suites and Lounge, located in Adeleke Street in Ikeja. It's a wonderful environment. The ambience is wonderful. Everything that's happening here is very, very cool. So please, guys, make sure you check it out. If you're in Ikeja, you're in Everest, if you're anywhere on the mainland and you need a place to stay, just make sure you come to 11.
It's nice. I like it.
You heard Uriel. It's nice. So guys, please, thank you very much. The comments keep rolling in. My brothers and sisters, if we stay here, we know we'll come out today. You understand? People
it's just true.
Want to keep interacting with you, and we really hope that you do that. So just share your social media handles for for all the.
So you can get me on Instagram, Uriel, Uriel Music Star. Simple, Uriel Music Star. And it's the same for my Twitter. My Facebook is Uriel Ngozi Oputa. But just hit me up on Instagram and I will surely answer your questions, interact with you more. So Uriel Music Star, hit me up.
Okay, guys, thank you very, very much. And please make sure you look out for Uriel. And those of you that have flying the flag, continue sending your
prayers. Hey, Biko, no. Biko.
Edinburgh.
Biko, no.
Biko, no. Biko, no. Support Uriel, the brand. And guys, thank you very much. Till we come your way once more, it's been a wonderful interview. My name is Abisola Alaode. And you could truly kiss my way now. I thought you said I was a celebrity.
I beg you.
That's not fair.
No, I beg you.
Guys, thank you very, very much for your time.
Don't leave me. Don't leave me. Come back.
Till we meet, we come your way again. Thank you.
Please
very much.
Stay. Wait. 1 minute. Joking.
Guys, thank you. Okay. It was wonderful.